to the ring first. Give it up for Fabian Limo.
Ready for bout number 13. Six rounder in the junior middleweight division.
Out of the blue corner, he's representing Tanzania, Africa. Fabian Little Kilimanjaro Limo.
So we got Limo and Vernon Brown.
On deck. Corner. He's representing Chicago, Illinois.
We've got somebody from the African continent taking on somebody from Chicago right here in Shelbyville, Kentucky.
That's awesome. Small world.
Yeah, we've had some international flavor tonight.
And like I said, sometimes, you know, I'm not familiar with the guys, and it you know, it's just as exciting for me because then I get to see new talent out here.
Here we go. First round, junior welterweights. Vernon Brown taking on.
He's got a
Fabian Limo.
His trunks say Sub Zero.
Vernon Brown in the blue trunks.
See, Sub-Zero.
Sub-Zero on them. And,
fitting for the weather we've been experiencing lately, huh?
Well, you got that right.
Woo! Man. It's pretty quiet in here.
Yeah. Oh, nice uppercut. Yeah, it's a little quieter after the last couple fights.
It doesn't look like any of the crowd has left, though.
No,
it's like everybody's
still a packed house.
Even some of the fighters that have fought earlier. Tim Moten's still over there. He's not going anywhere right away. Now they ride over us here, exchanging blows.
A lot of the fighters are probably sticking around for the next fight.
That's awesome.
When DeMontez Juicy Duncan makes his pro debut after winning several national championships, a really storied amateur career. He's up next, and this crowd is going to erupt. When I went to the restroom, there were several people with Juicy Duncan signs in the crowd and everything.
Like I said, was he the number one fighter amateur in his weight class or number two?
At one time, he was ranked number one in the nation in his weight class.
I know I've been watching him.
He's won so many big tournaments that I can't even name them all.
Yeah, I've been watching him back and forth between Indiana and here over the last few years.
Yeah, he's
and very exciting. Nice young kid. Super impressed. I'm kind of surprised he went pro as quickly as he did. But with the pandemic and everything the way it was, I think it almost, you know, it took the amateur –
Well,
took
I think
some amateurs out of the game.
Well, I think, and I don't know this, but 10 seconds to go before the end of round one, I believe Juicy is probably just had so many amateur fights it was time to turn pro.
I said it's taken some of the amateur fighters out of it because either they're we had some in Indiana that were too old. They were right there at the 40 marker, so it was going to put them out, and they trained last year, was going to fight in the Golden Gloves in Indiana. Season got canceled, tournament got canceled, so needless to say, their dreams are done. Some of the other guys, they, you know, some of the amateurs, they lose the desire to train when they don't have a fight.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and it's not, it takes a lot of hard work and the diet.
It's not just the amateurs that do that.
This is true, right. But I see it. I see more of it personally with the coach doing the coaching. I see it more from the amateur level than with the professional athletes. But it's a year layoff for anybody that does this. You could put on a lot of weight. You could lose a lot of cardio, and just kind of lose your drive. You know, your desire to want to compete like this because it just takes so much dedication.
Here we go for round two.
We all know it ain't no fun to cut weight all the time and be trying to, you know, avoid all that delicious food that we want to eat because we're competitive. That was a
nice straight left for Brennan Brown. Brown in the blue trunks with the, what would you call that color? Is that chartreuse?
Yes.
Trim?
Yes.
And
Like the fishing, like the fishing tackle.
That's the only reason I know that. And he's facing all the way from Africa, Fabian Limon. I hope I'm saying that right.
Limo.
Oh, okay. Well, then I've been calling him the wrong name.
And I hope I'm saying it right, too. Yes.
What?
Oh!
Nice straight left hand. Nice straight left
down. Vernon Brown with
a beautiful counter straight left hand.
Wow.
Right down the middle. Caught him clean. Fight over.
Nice. Boy, that was a clean shot.
One punch.
Man, oh, man.
One punch, and out Limo goes. He's up on his feet. He wasn't unconscious,
but he
couldn't beat the count.
No.
So it looks like he's going to
down. He went down kind of awkward, too. Yeah. His arm went back. He was all the way on the side of his face. Yeah, that was a good shot.
Yes, it was.
Man.
Spectacular straight left hand.
Oh, so all you watching on the live broadcast, that was a great shot. That's the only knockdown? Is that the only knockdown tonight?
Yep. Oh, no, not the only knockdown.
No.
But only knockdown in this fight.
For sure.
Yeah. No, there's been
one of the more significant knockdowns. Mm-hmm. Let me say that right.
That was a flash left hand that landed right on the button.
Damn, that was a good shot now.
Yes, it was. And speaking of people watching us on the internet, on the broadcast, why don't you tell everybody what you just told me off the air about how many countries are
we? So we got 10 countries watching right now.
That's fabulous.
And I would believe there's more than that, but we'll see. It's just nice to know that you're all out there watching. We hope you're enjoying yourself. Tim and I are having a great time here tonight. We got the whole cast here from Live Sportscaster. Got a lot of great fighters in the house. A lot of great coaches and trainers.
1 minute, 33 seconds in the second round. Winner by knockout. Vernon Sub-Zero Brown.
There you have it. Vernon Sub-Zero Brown gets a key knockout victory with a straight left hand that went right down the pipe, stopping Fabian Lamo. Lamo drops to 23 wins, 14 losses, 2 draws. Lamo has a lot of fights. He's a very experienced veteran, so that's a really good win for Vernon Brown.
In dominating fashion like that, for sure.
Yes, it was.
Lawrence Promoters, you got a lot of people in Chicago that tune in this night. What do you want to tell your people from Chicago?
Man,
thank y'all. I love y'all. And I know this ain't got nothing to do with boxing. But today, my mama, where she at?
My mama,
she celebrated 18 years clean.
All right. Chicago what? Chicago.
That's outstanding.
Got a winner in the house tonight. That was good. That was very quick.
You love to hear a story like that.
Quick, clean, concise fight.
Straight left, right down the middle, right on the button.
Yeah, that's good. That's the way you do that.
Is everybody ready for about 14?
Expect to hear this crowd